Right, so this should be, hopefully everything should be working pretty okay now. But here we are, guys, jumping into game number one of the... What am I doing? Alright, sorry about that, guys, but here we are for PewCraft game number one. This should actually be pretty exciting, and we are going to jump straight into it. But there's going to be map number one, Catalita, spawning down here at the bottom right. Playing for himself, it is going to be none other than Symbol, as the blue Zerg player. His opponent on the left-hand side, hopefully all the settings are okay, it's 4-minute delay, it should be fine. And on the left-hand side, playing for Team Planet Key Dynamics, we have Oz. He has the barcode for this game, but he's gonna scout his opponent pretty fast as he is heading in the right location, it looks like. And that's gonna be a nice little win here. As a Protoss going for a Forge first, it should be. You definitely want to know what your opponent is going for. And yeah, there's a 4-minute delay, guys, so that's what you're waiting for right now in the stream. I just had to reset it. And I just typed you in the chat as well. But there's the spawning pool, so he sees that this should be a Forge first based on the fact that this probe is here so fast. So he's gonna obviously go for this pool first, just to make sure that if some sort of cannon rush did happen... Hello, Jimmy. There's your shout-out. Then he's, you know, he's not really gonna die, and we do see the Forge first in production here. So, you know, the hatchery first, if it did go down, could easily get destroyed or killed off or forced to cancel or something like that. And Oz is going to go for that Nexus in a moment's time when he hits 400. He's actually going to have to wait a moment's time, though. And, ooh, if they're going down by here by Symbol. Okay, against a Forge, it should be okay. He does need to make sure he gets some Zerglings and keep an eye on the probe. He has to find the probe to make sure that there is no, you know, cannons going down or anything like this. Oz is going to come up here. He left the pylon finish. So this is going to keep the natural... You know, this is going to stop the natural going down for quite a while. The Zerglings are in production right now. We do have the Queen, because of course he needs to kill this off as fast as possible. The gases will be added on in, you know, about 20, 30 seconds time. Cannon in a nice position by here, it looks like. It should be, at least. Alright, let me know about the sound, guys. It's it can be a bit fidgety to figure out the sound. And yeah, everything's looking perfectly fine. The pylon gets picked off. The natural hasn't been taken just yet. It should be in a moment's time. And the Queen is headed towards our third base location. Because, of course, it's kind of important to get the third saturated or get the creep going and stuff like that, too, of course. Because this is normally the base that'll be attacked first. So you want the static defense there, or the abilities to defend there as fast as possible. The creep makes that easier. Subnexco will get added on. Nice war. The gas is a little bit late here, so he's not going to have a massive amount of gas when the subcore finishes. But he should have enough for maybe a plus one. If he doesn't go for the plus one, the Stalker and the Warp Gate, maybe a Mothership core if he's a little bit lucky, but normally you're not so much. You're like, you have to be very careful with these gas timings very early. Everything's in production. No gases from the Zerg just yet, so Symbol's not looking to be aggressive, it seems. He just wants to... pretty much just macro up as hard as possible. Let's just make sure I am tagged into... no, no. There. And Warp Gate in production. So there's the Stargate follower by Oz in a nice position here. This shouldn't get spotted, but actually this Overlord should... maybe... you would have to produce a Stalker right now and Corona boost the bejesus out of it. He's not going to. It's going to get spotted. So there should be an Oracle opening. Oracle is the most popular as it stands. You can go into Phoenix if you like, but... there's less of a chance to follow up with that transition, as, you know, spores, stuff like that make it very, very hard, and of course they, you know, they can detect the hydras and just annihilate you. The Stalker is in production. Nothing coming out of the Forge just yet, and force gas getting taken at 6 minutes and 20 seconds, so I think this could be a Robo soon after, just because he's going to have a lot of resources banked. He doesn't have enough for the Oracle just yet, and a Twilight instead, actually, so... maybe some sort of blink follow-up. There's the Oracle, as we can see right now. And... yeah, so that's pretty good. But the spores are in production in preparation for this oracle, so I don't see it doing too much. We'll have to wait and see, though. Got all the spores, the queens are ready. Tech of the Zerg hasn't kicked in just yet. He's barely got that much cash. He can go for his lair, which is what we're kind of waiting for. But he does want to build 13 drones before this attack or this oracle flies in, which is a good choice, because he's not going to lose that many drones. So he's going to be ahead. The blinker's started. No plus one attack coming out of the Protoss or shields or anything like that. So that's going to be interesting. Of course, he went to plus one just to do extra damage. But here comes the oracle. He's not going to get any kills. One, actually. But it took a lot of damage onto the hull there as well. So he can't really fly in and aggravate the main anymore. Speed has now started. No, he cancels it, goes for Burrow, which is actually a very intelligent move against something like Blink. There's not going to be an Observer. There is an Oracle which does grant him vision, so if he does save the energy and doesn't lose the Oracle, he will have detection. We'll have to wait and see, though. The Burrow is a brilliant move. Spinecrawl is getting added on. He can see that there's no third base, so he knows that to an extent there's attack coming. Yeah, there's no third, he doesn't see a massive army or anything like that, so it's either a third base or an attack. That's what the Protoss do after two bases. So he's coming down here. We've got quite a few units. One sentry though, and the mothership core doesn't have that much energy, so recall is not going to be very hard. There's 11 roaches, and we also have the roach speed as the lair does finish up. So the roach is going to have burrow, they're going to have roach speed, so they're going to be able to burrow during the fight and not take much damage, and then at the end of the fight they're going to be able to unburrow and chase the units down because they're going to be faster apart from the Blink Stalkers. But yeah, with the sentry, stuff like that is dead. Of course, it all comes down to if Oz can actually do this. He does have a nice attack area here. The Conclave will favor him. Symbol has two spine crawlers in a nice position. The Queens are getting close to the creep as well. I like this, just to make sure the units can reinforce that much faster. Oz is going around. Could plant a pylon right for that. But this is a big Conclave for both the players. Forward Blink there from Oz. Doesn't get a roach, burrows a couple of them. The Oracle is here with the Envision available. If it wants, the Queens could snipe it down. And they go into Envision. Is not available. There's a time warp. The Roaches can burrow. There is no speed yet. They are fighting off creeps, so they're pretty slow. They should be very, very careful against this. And another engagement. Queens still here. The Blink Stalkers trying to do their best. Zealots again warped in here just as a bit of a meat shield. But there's just not that many units here. Four Oz, the Stalkers, they're whittling down. There's only 19. There's 16 Roaches and 6 Queens. Holy crap, that's a lot of Queens. And he is microing very well. The Roach numbers are dropping. The regeneration is coming in. Reinforcements joining the fight. And the Overlords are getting picked off, which is slightly important because there's not that much room right now for Symbol to deal with this. And coming up here, he's going to try and go into the natural. He could maybe blink out here from this point, but at this point it doesn't look like it's going to be a cost efficient trade, and he's going for the final stand. It looks like the Stalkers are blinking onto the high ground. The vision is still here, and the micro is very good, but look how hurt these Stalkers are. They don't really have much left in them, and blinking onto the low ground, only 6 left, and the GG gets called.